such a beautiful encounter between Yaakov to Esav, full with love it seems, after 34 years of separation, or maybe actually it's full with hate, at least from one side. On the surface, it looked like Esav missed and loved Yaakov, as it says in the Pasuk, and he fell on his neck, kissed him, and they cried. But the Midrash teach us that's not what happened exactly. Esav said, I'm not able to kill Yaakov with my bow and arrow, because all the angels know, we know, came and beat his armies before, but rather I'm going to kill him and suck his blood. Don't read Vayashkeo when he kissed him, but rather Vayashkeo when he bit him. But there was, Baruch Hashem, a miracle to Yaakov, and his neck became like marble, and Esav was not able to bite him, and actually his teeth broke. Exactly as Esav want to destroy Yaakov, his brother, the father of the, one of the forefathers of the Jewish nation, also the nations, his children, especially Edom, all over the history until today, exactly as Esav tried in the beginning with weapons, bow and arrow, also the nation tried to destroy Klal Yisrael, the Inquisition, the Holocaust, and many, many, many other times in the history. But when they see that's nothing going to help, and still the Jewish nation cling and even more stronger to the Father in heaven, all of a sudden they change their way. Try to kiss us, be nice to us, teach us their language, their culture, their habits, their foods, in order to try to be metameas from the inside and create a separation between us to Hashem. Exactly as the story, the parable on the sun and the storm and the person. The sun and the storm said, let's bet who's going to be able to make this person take off his jacket, his coat. Started the storm with rain, crazy wind. The person suffering closed his jacket, bundled himself up, was not able to do it. Came the sun, nice, warm, and the person took his jacket. But we need to remember and never forget that the history already proved that even when the nation tried to smile to us, they doesn't want us to be close. They want to abuse, use us, and destroy us. The only power which is in our hand is the power of the Torah, as we learned that the voice of Yaakov is the one going to be able to conquer, win, and overcome Esav, the nations. As we know, and if you're going to look on the words Esav, the inner words, Ayin, Yud Nun, and then Shin, Yud Nun, and Vav, Yud Vav, the inner letters come to the numerical value of 136, exactly as the word Kol, the voice of the Torah. And this is the only way to be able to overcome all the trouble that's come upon us and to be able to overcome the tricks of the nations by the voice of the Torah and by fulfilling the Torah. Have a beautiful and meaningful Shabbat. Come close to Hashem. Bring close your fellow Jew to Hashem. Nachat Ruach Klal Yisrael, Parashat Vayeshlach.